Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at using the new color choosing tools in Pages, Numbers, and Keynote for iOS. So with the new update to Pages, Numbers, and Keynote last week, we've got a new way to select colors. It's something called a color picker. And we've actually had this on the Mac for a long time, but this is the first time it's appearing on the iPad. In addition to that, we have an eyedropper tool. I'm going to show you those both. So you can select colors for lots of different things. Like for instance, I'll select some text here, and then I'll use the paintbrush tool. And then under style there, I'll select where it says 11-point Helvetica color. And you can see these different ways to choose color. I can swipe between. So I can like go through these here, and I can even go now to this new version of the color picker here where I could pick some different things. But the real color picker, the one that kind of looks like what you've got on the Mac, is here where you can kind of adjust the angle here, and then you can go with hue and saturation at the bottom. And adjust those. So you can really pick any color you want out of millions because you have a lot of control. But what I really want to show you is something called the eyedropper tool, which you see there at the bottom left. Before I do that, let's create some more space here by editing. Instead of some text, we'll create just a box here. And then I'll take this box here and I'll move it, and I will you do the same thing with the paintbrush tool. I'll go to Style Options, and here's where I can choose color, and I can see all the different color options here I can choose, and including the selection there and including the ability to easily change to any color I want using these tools. And now to use the eyedropper tool, I go to the bottom, and the bottom I see the most recently used colors that I've used. So if I select a certain color for some text, I can very easily just tap one of those color chips there at the bottom to select it. But the first one on the left is a little eyedropper tool. I'm going to tap that. And now it all goes away, and I get this message at the bottom, drag across the color to apply it. So I'm going to tap down with my finger and keep holding down. And you see as I move my finger, whatever my finger is over, which appears just under the circle physically, that's what appears in the circle, and that's what the color changes to. So I can move my finger here over the barn or that shed there, and you can see red. If I want to select this blue, I can move over here and I can release, and now I've got that color change there. If I look at the tools again, I can see that that blue has been added as the most recent color chip at the bottom left. So now I have the ability to actually choose any color I want from anywhere on the screen on my iPad. So what about on the iPhone? So here I am in Pages on the iPhone. I've got a similar document here. I'm going to select this box, and it works a little different because it doesn't give you the color picker, but it does give you the eyedrop tool. So I'm going to hit the paintbrush there, and you can see it's a very different way to select colors. You've got just this long list, horizontal list here, and on the right you've got no fill and you've got the color chips, but you don't have the color wheel. I'm going to select the color chips, and if I actually scroll up in the color chips, I'll see them all, but I also notice in the toolbar there I see the eyedropper tool at the right. So I'm going to tap the eyedropper tool, and now I can do the same thing I was doing before, where I can actually position my finger somewhere over this image and select a color.